Hi and welcome to my YouTube video. Today we are going to install this Blu-ray drive into my computer. You need, of course, the Blu-ray drive. You need a screwdriver, and if you use one like me that's magnetic, be careful not just waving it around inside the computer. Then you need some screws. I have four here. And then you need this SATA cable. So, let's get to it. The first thing you have to do is to remove the sides of your computer. I have already done that. And then on the front of your computer, you should have some plastic things looking a little bit like this. They can be different to remove, but mine is just plastic, so I'll just go in here and push a little bit to this little latch here. So with that gone, we can go. Just slide the computer down. Normally you would use a table, but I don't really have one right now. Because a bed, it's not really the smartest idea. So you just put in the drive here, nice and easy. And don't use any violence, that's not good. And then you just simply take these four screws and you put them in here. Nice and gently. Now my Blu-ray drive here is in my computer, but I don't know if you really can see it, but it's not quite... It has to be... There must be no way that it's sitting like this, because that will increase the... There you see, that was a lot better, because if it doesn't sit right in the option of wrong discs and broken discs and everything will be a lot higher. And as you saw, I used all four screws. That's very important because the drive shakes a lot when it's in use. And if you don't use all four screws, you get a lot of shaking inside the computer, and that increases the chance of wrong discs. Broken disc when you burn them. And then you need to put in this SATA cable. This is going to be a little difficult for me to show you because I have a lot of cables inside this computer. But notice there is a little pin going the other way here. You'll have to match that with the computer's bottom down here. So I'll just see if I can put this in. I'm sorry if you can't see that much right now. There. And I'll just route the cable through here. My enormous graphics card and everything here. No, this is a mess. This is not really a good way to have all your cables organized, but it's just for a short amount of time. And make sure you are careful with this. These cables are a little bit sensitive. And make sure again to match it up here in the drive itself. I have to turn mine a little bit around here. So that is the SATA cable that provides the data, and here is the power cable, SATA power cable. So I'll just put that in. Again. Just have to get a couple of cables out of the way here. I guess that's what my graphics we are up and fighting a little bit with here. Just move it a little bit like this. That's it. Oops. There. And let's see, this cable is going in like this. And again, be a little bit careful when you do this, so you don't damage anything. There. So they don't sit. I don't know if you can see, but I have some cooling, passive cooling on my memory. It's not good if the cables are lying right up against them, because they generate a lot of heat. So, that was pretty much it, how to put in the Blu-ray drive. And in a second we'll have a little look at what software do you need to play Blu-ray movies. So, now I have my computer plugged up again, and I have been sitting and downloading and testing, downloading and testing, and now I finally found something that works. I'm going to show you a demo of this movie running on my computer. Death Race, a great movie. And I'll just put it into my new Blu-ray drive that we just installed. Here. And I found the application CyberLink PowerDVD 9. And make sure you get the Ultra Edition. It costs some money, yes, but that's the only application I've bumped into that actually works. And if you want to play Blu-ray movies on your computer, I just contacted some stores here in Denmark where I live. You got to have a screen that supports this HD format. Yeah, I guess you can talk to your store. And then you will need a graphic card that also can use it. I have an ATI Radeon HD 8400 in my computer. And the whole 8400 series from ATI supports it. So, now we have the film going here. I'm just trying to skip all these ads here. You can, when you go full screen here, you can just use the arrow keys on the keyboard to switch around. That's pretty nice. What I have here is an Acer monitor with the, and that's the model V200 3H, and that does support. And I'll just get all these warnings. I won't show you the whole film because I don't think Universal is going to thank me for that. I'm just going to show you that it works. And of course, it was CyberLink PowerDVD 9 that I used for this. And if I read right somewhere, it should be built into Windows 7, and it arrives around September, I think. So let's just skip all these ads, and here comes the menu. There. And if you haven't seen this movie, Death Race, I will strongly encourage you to do so. This is an extraordinary movie. This is very cool. Very good movie. So let's try and jump into some action here, around here.
You can't go head to head with Joe like this. He'll tear you apart. You read me?
Listen to him. Poyter spoke to him.
Okay, come out of there.
It's a shortcut to the left. There.
Take the shortcut. You don't think I'll see that?
I guess this is quite difficult for you to hear, but there is also surround sound on this video. Thank you for watching.